thugs vandalized Ben Carson's home, his reply will make you stand and applaud. Secretary of Housing Dr. Ben Carson is clearly one such individual. One does not rise to prominence in a profession such as infant brain surgery unless one is an extremely bright and gifted person. The way he comported himself during the acrimonious Republican primary campaign was exemplary, and he is serving with distinction as Housing Secretary. He also offers some wise advice regarding the recent tragedy in Charlottesville. Actually, it's not a new strategy at all, just one that many find difficult to implement. That strategy would be to take the high road and refuse to lower yourself to violent debate with bigots and simpletons. This is not a cowardly approach at all, but one that requires poise, wisdom, and self-confidence, virtues Dr. Carson possesses in abundance. Much of this relates to the recent vandalizing of Dr. Carson's Virginia home with racist graffiti while he and his wife were out of town. Of course, this is a result of the tragedy in Charlottesville and his affiliation with President Trump as well as his support for President Trump's remarks. From Breitbart. Vandals posted hateful rhetoric about President Donald Trump on a Virginia house owned by Housing Secretary Ben Carson. In response, Ben Carson is urging Americans to avoid the emotional conflicts caused by the far-left effort to tear down Confederate era memorials. Racist hatred and bigotry unfortunately still exists in our country and we must all continue to fight it, but let's use the right tools, such as people taking the high road, he wrote. Reconciliation is the likely outcome if we just learn to be neighborly and to get to know each other, Carson wrote in an August 16 post on his Facebook page. The problem the left has is that some of its more prominent leaders benefit politically and financially by keeping racial tensions stoked. Derelicts such as those in the KKK and other despicable white supremacist groups, as well as those agitators in groups such as BLM, financed by public nuisances such as George Soros, are unwitting tools in this effort to divide Americans according to racial lines. And Carson well understands this. On August 12, Carson commended Trump's criticism of the white power fascists and the progressive street fighters for brawling in Charlottesville. He wrote, "Let us pray for those killed and injured during the unrest in Charlottesville today, but also for our nation as it is being severely threatened by hatred and bigotry on all sides. I am pleased that the president overtly disavowed any relationship with white supremacists. We should all reject the forces of division on all sides of the political spectrum." Feel free to read the entire Facebook post, it's excellent. This is a man who knows how to rise above the situation, take the high road, speak the truth, and propose solutions which if actually employed on a widespread basis, would reduce tensions and the potential for a repeat of such tragedies. Let us hope that Dr. Carson's remarks are heard and considered across the political and racial spectrum.